be able to hear me right now, I hope. And okay, good. Okay, good. Okay, guys. Sorry for this kind of crazy beginning here. I just decided I had to change a part in my computer from Costa Rica. Sweet. Juniper. Okay. So I had to tweak a part of my computer, and I didn't realize that in tweaking it, that it was going to reset all the settings. So everything has kind of been reset tonight, so I am kind of in the process of trying to clean this mess up a little bit. And if you'll bear with me one second, I think I've pretty much got it. Okay. Let's see. Okay. So, welcome everybody. Thank you for joining me tonight. Over there in the corner is my partner and partner in this household, Tara. And we are happy that you are joining us. Tara has been hooping, seriously hooping, for about 2 years. Would you say that? About 2 years. I like having her as a resource for you guys, because you can kind of see she's also a professional mover. She teaches movement. She's big time. She has a dance background. And so my hope is that you can kind of, see another interpretation of what I'm doing. And sometimes, quite often, what we're doing, she's never done before. So, okay, so let's see. I think I got everything now tweaked for ready for us to go here. We are going to. There we go. Okay, and there we go. Okay, okay, sweet. Okay, I think I got everything tweaked. Sorry about that. 7:15. We better get going. Tonight's a class that's going to be on lifts, paddles, and vortex thingies. I think their name was Gil on YouTube. I will recheck that. If I got your name wrong, I'm really sorry. I don't know if we're going to get to all the moves you requested. I didn't have time. I'm in school, and because of this computer thing, era, I had to go to Durham today. So I didn't get to look up all the moves, but I've got a couple in mind from my old school days. I am trying to record this again. I did a test recording. I was successful. So please let me know if things are if things are junky or unclear or whatever tonight. So far so good. Everything looks pretty hot. So make sure you tell me about my mic, if it's too high, if it's too low, or whatever. So tonight we're going to talk about paddles and lifts. We're going to do some basics with the lifts. We probably won't spend too much time there, but we're going to try to do some basics. Tonight's the kind of night you might want to hide the lampshades and things like that, and sort of hoop-proof your room real fast. And we're also going to be working on paddles. I've done this a few times. Maybe this is the old man yelling at the cloud, but a lot of what people think are paddles are just brakes. Like, I'll see people talk about their paddles and brakes, and I don't know how they're looking at it, because, like, even if you look at salt and pepper as being this, connected tandem, there's still salt and there's still pepper, right? And so a paddle is definitely not a brake. And so just to make this super clear, I try to make it clear in my description. A brake is when you stop the momentum of the hoop's direction. Okay, so you stop the momentum that it's traveling. A paddle is when you assist or hardly affect the momentum of the hoop. The idea of paddling is, like, you would think of it almost like you know, like when you are paddling a canoe, right, you're not, like, unless you want to go backwards, you're sort of paddling with the direction that you want to go. That might be a way to think about this. It's so when I'm paddling, I am paddling the hoop in the direction that I want it to go, right? A break, I'm sending it the opposite direction of what it's going. With a paddle, I'm going with its already established flow. I had this big moment in my hoop journal once. I tell the story all the time, so I won't bore you with it. But, you know, I kept a hoop journal. I tried to keep a hoop journal after I'd been hooping for 5 or 6 years, and I would never remember to put entries in. But one of the entries I put in, and all I wrote was, lifts are paddles. And I hope to explain that later in the class so you can understand what we're talking about. Okay, again, I apologize for the late start. This is sort of 2 weeks where we've had tech issues. We had gone a long run without these, so thanks for bearing with me on this. I'm going to be playing music from my personal library tonight, so if there's a song that you like, I love it when you tell me. But also, you'll see the music info box, and you can see that box and then snap a picture of it or write it down or whatever. Okay, cool. This will work. Okay. So I want to go ahead and get started here. Again, I apologize for the late start. Okay. All right, let's get going here. And we're going to go ahead and start with Sway. Tonight we're going to start with a little bit faster sway than we normally do. Not too bad, but just a little bit faster. Taken sway with me before. It's a free-form movement stretch time. And it's made more and more special by how independent and free of any other sway you've ever done. Of us we refer to as day. The space behind us we refer to as night. Audible breath in. Our day is a space we move our body into. Our night is a space we move our body into. If I fold forward, I'm folding into day. If I lean back, or step back, or pull my arms back, moon and tonight. If I roll my shoulders, I'm rolling them from day up across and into night. Audible breath in. Split into two trees. You have a left tree and a right tree. Your feet are the roots. The more broad your roots, the firmer the base, the more sturdy the position. Now my leg is in night, my body is in day. Switch legs, I give each tree an opportunity to carry my weight, to balance me. Auto breath in. Our legs. The older we get, the harder this can be to do, the less forgiving it could be to do. But it keeps things alive down there, keeps our legs feeling strong. Audible breath in. So we're going to get warmed up now. We're going to switch to a mix that I like. I don't think I've played it for you guys before, but again, I am, let's see, let's get back on here. I am trying to record this right now. So if it seems, if it gets junky or weird, it's probably getting a little digital looking when I have all the cameras going. I've got to fix that, that little multi-camera thing. That's a problem. I'm gonna get rid of that. But in general, the quality should look good. If it starts to lock up, please let me know. I'm trying to record and that's why it's locking up if it gets weird. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started here. Actually, you know what I think we should do maybe is, I know I just started this song. Yeah, I'm sorry, y'all. I gotta switch the song. I think I just changed my mind. Maybe. Okay, this will work. Okay, we'll come back to that. Okay, but before we do that, we need to, let's see. Before we do that, we need to warm up the core here. So we're on the waist. Big breath in, big breath out. Now we're going to go ahead and guide you. This one might be the one that's a little blurry. That's right. This one might be the one that's, maybe the one that's blurry. But here's what we're gonna work on tonight. Just because we're gonna be working mostly on the arms, we wanna get our core timing, core hooping timing and our hands together. This might be the blurry one. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna move our arms around almost as if they're on like a dial. And we're gonna go back the other way. And then I'm going to free you up, of course, to move any way you want to. But I want you to think about keeping the elbows high, to keep them at, like, shoulder height, like I've got them now. I told this story in workshops before, but I spent the better part of a year on my own in my practice just dancing like this. And the strength that it brought to my shoulders and to my arms was kind of remarkable to me. I felt so much stronger. The foot pan looks a little weird. Reverse. And now what I want you to do is to think about moving, having one hand forward. And it might help with that. Actually, I'll move it into, never mind. But have one hand forward and one hand backward. Let's try this first. And then we're going to switch hands, right? So it's going to look like this. And I want you to just move at whatever rhythm, you know, feels good. But ultimately, I want you to see if you can start to feel as though your hand movement is syncing up with your body movement. And what I mean by that is that when one hand comes forward, you're going to be stalling. You're going to be turning with the hoop. And when one hand comes backwards, probably, if you're turning with it anyway, we'll be cutting, all right? So I got one hand out, one shoulder back, and then I switch that. And you'll feel a difference down at your core. Do you feel what I'm talking about, too? One motion is stalling. Stalling is when you're turning with the hoop. Cutting is when you're turning against the hoop. And if you do this enough, like if you stretch and push out enough, now not everybody's into the same thing, but I have done this with like wrist weights or holding dumbbells. Some people told me I was doing too much weight there. It wasn't that much. It was like, I think 7 pounds each. But some people just do 2 pounds. But I have actually found that to be really helpful for building up strength. Especially, you know, like for me, it would make me a little sore, but like a good sore. And then if you know how to, we're going to come up to the shoulders. And then we're going to like take a whole class and condense it down into about 30 seconds. But we've talked about pulses at the shoulders. And pulses are when you push an arm out. I'll show you give you a better angle for this. So shoulders, this is when you push out, right? So watch my arms. You see how they're coming up? Or I can push with my whole core, but my arms are moving. Okay? And we're not going to stay here. This isn't a shoulder class. But since paddles are kind of a shoulder movement, we're going to start there. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and get into the... We're going to go ahead and get into tonight's actual class. This is a mix from Aligning Minds. Oh, no. All right, my camera skills been lacking lately. Okay, there's better. Okay. All right, so we're going to, all right, I'm going to start with some basic lifts here, okay? Now, these have different names in the flow community. I teach the HoopPath. The HoopPath has a whole curriculum. Most of those terms and phrases came from me or came from my students or came from other HoopPath teachers, okay? So here's the way we're going to talk about this, and I'm going to show you, this is a good way to do it on my bird's eye camera here. Okay, so right now, my hoop is traveling to the left. Okay, it's traveling to the left. So for those of you at home, this is my right arm and this is my left arm, okay? So when we name the two trees as they go around, and we have two names for them, but they mean the exact same thing. One came first and it was easier for the other one. The first name we ever came up with, because we're two trees, is that as the direction of the hoop is spinning around you, as it spins onto my day side, which is this front super overlit side of me right now, that is my AM tree. That's, you imagine the sun, the point of contact is the sun. It is rolling on to my AM tree, and then it rolls onto my first tree, AM tree, to my second tree, PM tree. So we call it AM, PM, or first and second. So if you are going, I'll make this super easy. If you're going to the left, okay, then your first tree or your AM side is your right hand. Because if I freeze it, that's where the point of contact rolls onto the front of my body, okay? Now, if I'm going to the right, okay, then my first tree is my left side, okay? My AM first tree, same thing, my left side, and it goes to my right side. Okay, this is really cute with Rex here. But one way to keep it easy, if it's going to the right, then your right tree is your PM side, because that's gonna be the last side. So if it's going to the right, that you think of like the day is traveling to PM, okay? So hopefully that will help you. So if I wanna do a super simple paddle at the waist, I can do an AM paddle or a PM paddle. PM paddles are the easiest. So the hoop is going to my left. You can turn. I'm not going to turn so I can face you. You can turn, move your feet, whatever. I'm going to dip this hand into the water, let the hoop roll across it, give it a little bit of a push, and that is a paddle. Okay? Now, if I've got a super big hoop, it's a little bit easier to do, but you can kind of go in and do one paddle. Uh-oh. Are we starting to lock up, guys? Let me know if we're... Okay, I think we are starting to lock up. Okay, well, let me know if we're locking up. Nobody's commenting. Maybe we are locking up. One. Okay, I think that's pretty good. Okay, let me know if we're locking up. Okay, so then an AM, a PM paddle, the hoop, I'm going to the left. I'll put my left arm in and I push the hoop that way, right? Those are the paddles that are usually the easiest, because the PM side... Okay, cool. Just let me know if anything starts to lock up, guys. I think I've got this figured out. Okay, so we're moving across. Twitch is good. Okay, cool. Okay, cool. Okay, nice. Thanks, y'all. Oh, good. Kelly's here. Everybody's here. Sweet. Okay, so if I want to start to link paddles at the waist, then what that means is if I go in with both hands at the waist and push... That's actually called a one tree paddle, because both hands are pretending that they're one tree instead of two. So I'll show you what that looks like. So that would be like me going in, and if I start to push just like this, that's it, right? It's gonna want to bring it up to the shoulders. It's kind of hard to almost keep a one tree paddle down there, okay? Now, if I want to alternate my paddles, right? Then that would be something like I go in and go in. Anybody that has ever said to me, I just don't get paddles, like they don't see why somebody would do them, I think they haven't been exposed to how much they can do. Because for those of you who've been taking HoopPath for a while, the first thing you can do is bring it up to the shoulders like crazy fast when you're paddling. Boom, 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 boom. Now, paddles can be lifts. And what that means is that a paddle doesn't have to just strike the hoop. A paddle can actually hit and then stay on the hoop. And we're gonna do an example of that right now. This is a super old school move where you're gonna go from like wrist to wrist or hand to hand, mostly wrist to wrist. I'm gonna stick the hoop in, I'm gonna turn with it, and my hands are meeting in front and they're passing the hoop back and forth. And you start to get tired, you start to get dizzy, you know, you can stop, you can turn the other way, you can reverse current, whatever. Yeah, I'm doing it on my wrist right now. Now I'm turning with it, and this is a key point, because as I turn with the hoop here, I'm keeping the window, that's what you call this open spot, this would be the window, I'm keeping that open longer by turning with it, right? If I turn against it, the window gets psycho fast. If I turn with it, now this is important, because our first lift can actually be learned off of this movement, and this is kind of what will open us up to a vortex. So if I'm here and I'm rolling with it and I'm into this thing here, when I bring it on, the next time I bring it on to my AM, so it's coming around me, when it hits this AM or first tree hand, instead of bringing it back around my body like this, I'm gonna spin it and bring it up. So I'm gonna spin it and bring it up, and there's gonna be a little bit of like a contact ball feeling on my hand. There's gonna be a little bit of sort of a movement there. So this is the move, and then this time I'm gonna bring it up, right? Okay. So I'm here, and I'm gonna bring it up. Now that's essentially, that's what we used to call a lift, and it is, but it's actually just a paddle, right? Because what makes these lifts smooth, and what I recommend to people when they're trying them, is to, rather than like flagpole it where everything is still and you're just throwing your hand up there, to feel the resistance and kind of push that resistance along. That resistance means that you and the hoop are in piace together, right? So you kind of want the weight of the hoop to feel pretty similar as it comes up. Now remember what I said about turning with the hoop? If I turn with it, then I can make this movement a lot less scary and a lot more doable, right? So watch me now. I'm gonna be doing this move here, and then I'm gonna slow up, and then as I'm coming up, see how I'm just turning? And even though the hoop is stalled there, it's still in the window, right? I'm still got it going, right? Good. Now, once we make a, all right, so then there's also, okay. Now, this is a little bit trickier. So we're going into this move, and this is called a PM hand lift, a PM hand or second tree lift. And we can do it from this movement also, but it's gonna be a little bit different. So what happens is that after we pass it, you know, it's gonna pass to this hand to lift it. You know, if we're going to the right, we lifted this last one with the right hand. You know, I'll do all this stuff the other way if you can't tweak it out. I mean, it can be done both ways. I do it both ways. You should do it both ways, okay? So, boom. That's what we just did, okay? Now, what we're gonna do now is we're gonna come off of here, but now as I pass it from this hand to this hand, right? Instead of getting it like this because I was taking it around me, I'm gonna be lifting it up. So I'm gonna have to dip my elbow down a little bit and pass it to a hand that is more like this in front of me. And I'll show you what I mean here, right? Now when I pass it from this hand, right? So I'll show you what I'm doing. So this is like what I would be doing if I was doing it one-armed, okay? So now turning with it to give me more time in the window, my right arm is gonna pass it to my left arm. If you're going the other way, it'd be your left arm to your right arm. That left arm for me is gonna dip down so I can get it up, okay? I will turn it with it to make it happen. And I'm probably gonna grab it like with my thumb and maybe this finger here, okay? So it's here, but pick it up, boom. Actually, I kinda went to the back of my hand for that one, but whatever, it doesn't really matter. Did you get it, T? Okay, so here's what it looks like, okay? So, just to make sure we're clear, you want, I'll show you what it looks like if we don't do it out of the paddle move. If I was just lifting it from my waist, it looks like this. Okay. So it's used to call, some people called it the hitchhiker, which wasn't a bad thing. Some people called it the seatbelt lift. but basically, you're going to dip the shoulder in. Make sure if it's going to the left, you're lifting it with the left hand. If it's going to the right, you're lifting it with the right hand. I'll show it. But this is now I'm going to the right. So I'm going to be lifting it with my right hand, right? Now, that's me not turning. But watch what happens if I turn with it. Look how smooth that is. Boom. And then how you, whatever cradle you use is whatever feels good. Sometimes it threads between your fingers. Sometimes it's on the back of the hand, whatever it is, okay? I don't know if I need to give you guys time to practice that. Probably everybody that's watching this can do these. But don't be embarrassed if you can't. There are some badass hoopers. These are such old school moves that some people just are super badasses. They got millions of followers, but you know, these, some of these basics they don't have just because they never were, they've never seen them. You're right, they're not that they can't do them. So if you, if you're having trouble with these in replay or live, don't worry about it. Okay, so just to review before we get lost, these are the paddles. This is a paddle, right? And then we were taking these paddles and turning them into lifts, right, from either hand. Now, once you have a lift, if you want to come back on the to the core, the other half of the vortex is what's called a drop-in, okay? And so when we drop in with the hoop, it's the same process as lifting it, where the hand kind of has to manipulate, like it has to move and be funky for a second. This happens with this hand. So for any like drop-in, the whatever the receiving hand is, in this case it'll be my left hand, I have to sort of let the hoop sort of move with me, and then when it's gonna, I'm gonna like roll it, like it's almost like I'm, like, imagine that you're inside like a velour tube, and you wanna run your hand along the wall of this curved tube. That would be kind of like what you're doing, but it's coming down and around, and it's gonna roll in your hand like that, the way my hand is up, it's gonna roll down most likely. So let me show you what this would look like. So I make a lift here, all right, that sort of AM lift. And if I wanna drop in, I'd switch to the other hand in my roll here, and then I'm gonna turn with it again, right, because that's gonna slow it down, and then I'm gonna bring it down, and then I give it just a little bit of a push when it drops back onto the body. I know this is super basic, don't worry, we're gonna get a little bit more advanced as this goes on, but this is a lift from the waist. And this is a drop-in back to the waist. You know, you can lift and drop in on with the same hand. You can do it continuously. Some people will do like, they'll keep it on the core the whole time. So, you know, I don't know, maybe it's called lasso or some shit like that, I don't know. But I'm gonna pick it up with my AM hand and put it back with my AM hand. And I'm gonna turn with it. And I just give it a little push just to keep the hoop nice and flat and crisp. Good. Now if I want to do it with my other hand, right, I'm in first current right now, so for me, I'm going to the left, so it'll be my left hand this time. It's going to pick the hoop up, and then it's going to put the hoop back down, okay? And if I want to do that all in one motion, if I turn with it, it's super cool. Sweet. Okay, good. Okay, now, if I'm going too fast, watch it tomorrow on replay. Hopefully we'll have a high-def version on there. But because we're running a little bit late already, yeah, we're running way late already, I'm gonna keep moving. So to do a vortex is basically a lift with your AM side to a drop in with your PM side. But when you drop in, you are actually dropping into this movement that we were already working on, which is this thing here, right? And so what a vortex does is it drops, there's two pickup and drop points. There's a point back here in my 12 and a point somewhere up here in my 12, like in my midday, my midnight, okay? So I'll show you what this looks like. So this is me picking that up in my first tree, right? Passing to my second tree. And when my second tree brings it down, it's gonna bring it down to a waiting AM hand. And then if I turn with this as I'm doing it, now, I'm not, everybody has their own ways of doing things. When I am trying to do a vortex, you know, we used to do a lot of these because this was, I used to go to like our local co-op for their music specials, and I would do this for about 4 hours because it was all I knew and I loved doing it. There's all kind of nuances to the vortex. You can spin it when it comes up and spin it when it comes down. If I lean back and push my shoulders out, it becomes kind of a workout, so it's a super fun move. No, so Terrence asked me, when I bring it up with my AM hand, yeah, you don't want to, if you can, you don't want to break the momentum, right? So I come up here and back down. And the hoop is, you'll feel the hoop kind of roll around this point up here, and I'm actually kind of turning it with my hand, like I'm almost turning closed the faucet, right? And so then what you can do with these vortex moves, and what I think the move that Gil wanted to know and some of the sort of funky vortexes that I used to do, was, you know, you can dip as low as you want. And you can do this thing that can be called an indirect pass. And that is when you drop the hoop onto the core and it rolls for just like a second, and then you pick it back up again. Okay, so I'll show you one at my waist, right? So this is me picking it up. I'm gonna let it hit my waist and come off. It's gonna hit my waist and then come off. Now, when I'm bringing it off the hoop, off my body, I'm turning my hand, right, to give it a little bit of tweak, right? Give it a little gas. If I let it hit the core, it's going to look like this. This is indirect because it's like a pass, but it's hitting the core first. So that's why we started to call it indirect. But don't worry about that. You don't need to know all the language. And I can do these higher and higher as I'm going. You see right now, I'm kind of going under the chest. And this could be a great way to like teach yourself shoulders or teach yourself a new way to move. Like I'm dropping it off. I don't know if it's because of the resolution you can see this. But it's hitting my upper back. It's almost running like around my arms here, right? Here we go. And you'll probably find that PM hand can be a real help in push. The thing about paddles that people don't understand is if they're fucking up your flow, it's because you're not doing them right, right? Because they should, the flow of the hoop, they should be speeding the hoop up, right? They are meant to be like an assist to the hoop. Now, I can do this also at the shoulders where I am dropping in, and now we're gonna keep our hands more in front of us. So I'm spinning the hoop on my hand. I'm going to the left, I'm using my left hand, I'm going to the right, use right hand. And I'm gonna drop into the shoulders, but just for a second, before I bring this other hand back up. Yeah, so I am dropping in with the PM arm, if you follow the terminology. I'm dropping in with the PM arm and raising with the AM. I'm doing an indirect pass, but I'm doing it across the back, right? Yep. Yep. This is the first time Tara's done this. If she gives it a little bit, if you give it a little bit more of a push when it comes on, it'll help crisp the hoop up, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. So when I'm here and it's time to push the hoop back on, I've got it in my left hand, it's gonna be going to the left. When I get down here, I'm gonna give it a little push, right? So when I come here, boom. And it's almost so simultaneous to the moment it touches you. Nobody's commenting, so we're either off the air, or everybody's trying, or we lost the room. This is kind of an aside, but for those of you that like samurai, this move gets even funkier because you can do quicker stops and stuff with it. So if I want it, I can pick up, drop here, but then samurai it, right? And then bring it back. So I'm going to the right now. I can samurai it, bring it back up. Now I'm going to the left. I can samurai it, fold out of it. So it's, you know, having indirect passes is kind of a good thing to have. And I'll tell you something else is that a lot of paddle lifts, right, same thing, are you pushing the hoop out, then bringing it back. Sometimes we miss that. Like, the reason it's hitting the lamp is it didn't come back. But you push it out and then bring it back in. There's this, like, snap to a lift. I'll show you a little bit about what I'm talking about. When I bring out, snap, back, out, snap, snap. You know, I can lift it, bring it down, but instead I can just go into a nice stall. I can put to a penny stall if I want. I could do a horizontal stall, leg stall, whatever. Little rolls, so lots of different fun things that you can do. Let me know if you have any questions. Well, all right, I definitely want to run class a little bit late. If you can't stay for the whole time, I totally understand. You can catch the replay, or if it's, you know, if it doesn't interest you, we can just move on. So the move that I think that some people have asked me about, and if this isn't the move, I'll get to this later. But the move with this is a funky little move that I used to do a long time ago. It's kind of hard, but it's an indirect pass. But what you do is if you're dropping in with your left hand, then what I recommend you do is you bring it down and you lift a leg and you drop into that ankle, okay? So it's kind of funky. Oh, hey, Laura. So here, if I wanted to know, this is super old school. Like, so just so y'all know, like, in, locally, they used to kind of like jokingly call this the Baxter, because I would do these. Wait, are we starting to walk? We're good. Okay, I think we're good. Okay, so this is the next move that I did that people seem to dig. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to the left. I'm going to use my left hand. I haven't done this in years. Yeah, okay, there we go. So what you do is you raise a leg. I'm doing left hand, left leg. And you're going to drop it down, and you're going to drop an indirect pass onto this foot. And then you're going to reach down with the other arm, and you're going to lift all the way up from wherever that point is. So I'm going to do this over and over again and give you a chance to see it. Oh, man. Right, clearly, I need to focus on this. There we go. You see what I'm doing? I'm dropping to the ankle. The ankle carries it a little bit. I'm actually turning with it some. Now, to make this work, when it comes down, this is why it can kind of hurt. You have to push it, right? So you're kind of slapping it onto the angle on your ankle at first. You'll get it after a while. So I'm down here and throw it onto the leg. Now, I can do the other leg. You don't have to do, so maybe, you know, maybe you like to drop from your left to your right. And then, of course, you can do this in any current. I just did both feet in second, my second. You know, and then as I bring it up, I can bring it up to a different place. Like, I didn't show you guys this, but this kind of relates to the move I just showed you. If I'm at the waist, right, like, I could just lift to my shoulders, right? I could just do a sneaky little quick lift to my shoulders if I wanted to, right? Or if I'm on my shoulders, I can just do a sneaky little, you know, paddle down to my waist. The reason I bring that up is that as I'm doing this crazy little vortex move, if I pick it up, I could just drop it back here, right at the shoulders. I don't have to bring it all the way back up, right? So that might make it easier for some of you. You try it, you know, it goes around the ankle, you lift it to the waist, maybe. So, but the secret to this is to not lose momentum, and that just takes a shitload of practice, right? Because you're trying to teach your body timing, you're trying to balance, you know, it's an easy looking move, but it's actually a little bit harder to get at first. Simple to, you know, hard to master, but it is rolling. So that's a good, so that ideally the hoop never loses its current. That's what I mean by not stopping. So you ideally with all of these moves, and that's the thing I put in the description, I just want to emphasize, if it's a paddle, then it's coming from its arm, the arm somewhere, the shoulder or something, and it's assisting, right? Or the upper arm, not the shoulder, but it's assisting, okay? Some people that can balance well, like to, you know, pull a leg out and drop the hoop down under there and do a balance, and then use that same move, you know, out of a balance to come off. So it's like, if you like into like one leg hooping or something like that. This is me reversing it at the waist. This is the Vortex with just a little bit more funk added to it. That's a samurai break down there. This is kind of like a one-handed sort of samurai vortex-y type thing. Would be here, there. I'll show you in the bird's eye because it might be a little bit easier to see. So this is kind of, if you can imagine, this would be like a half vortex with samurai grip. Uh-oh. What is that? See that? Yeah, yeah. Tara, we just took out our first lamp, so that's nice. All right, I'm not sure if I'm leaving you guys in the dust here or not, or if this is just so simple and then you're like, move on. I really stink at that move, Jen. I'll be honest with you. I am not that good at that one. With the like one leg thing, I just don't have that kind of balance. I have some good balance, I think, but it's not like that. Who is really good at that is Spiral. She actually does that. I've seen her do that in shows, and it just looks twice as good as anything. More than twice. It's good. Let me know if you have any questions about any of these things. And then this is just a little bit, I think I said paddles, lifts. So one thing I'll just kind of mention super fast here is for those of you that are, you know, more advanced and watching on a Thursday night Foundations class, one thing you can do is do these paddles and do these lifts in angles, right? Well, here's the vortex on an angle, right?
Sure,
I'm going here. I can show you what it looks like this angle. Oh, here we go. Wow, okay. Been a while since I've done this one. This is the vortex on an angle. I'll show it from the side one more time. I just reversed the vortex. Now I'm in what's my second current of a vortex on an angle. I remember back in the day, I was obsessed with doing a sky angle vortex, but I'm going to spare you guys because I haven't tried that in 10 years, and I don't know if I could even do it anymore. But what I can do and what I still do and still love to do are doing these kind of indirect passes while in an angle, right? So let's try, well, like if I was in earth angle, pulling it off and putting it back on, it's off. You see how it's rolling around my back? Okay. Same thing can happen up here when I'm back on sky angle. Nice, T. Now you probably either have to, that's a really hard thing. So what I do sometimes is when, if I'm like doing this move here, I cannot emphasize enough. You can even use these two hands to turn the hoop. Like turn it the direction, like you're, turn it, right? So that you can keep some mojo, keep some flow on the hoop. So I'm here, do that move. All right, I got it. See if I can do this. Oh, yeah, okay. Okay, I still got it. Here. Tell you, for me, what really helps, I'm going to the left. My left hand doing all this turning the hoop is really helping it stay sort of in an angle. Now, these are indirect passes. And this is that lift and drop in on the same hand in earth angle. That's earth, but sky, sky, sky. Oops. Right some more. If you like this mix, it's awesome. I got this. It's a free download on SoundCloud, right? You didn't have to even post it anywhere. It's under Aligning Minds. They're awesome. I've seen them play live a couple times. They're terrific. I think they're still together. For some people, the pandemic was a band killer. Okay, so I think that's probably good. And we'll just, I'll just switch over, play the music up a little bit loud. You can ask questions. I'll try to remember to be disciplined, and I'll try to show you guys when the cameras are on me some demo of some of the stuff that we're doing. Will be Monday, and it will be a Darsha class. It'll be a Myth and Flow class. Darsha was the blind my dance, so grab your blindfold. Watching 2015 me hoop today, and that kid could really move his feet around. I was like, I remember him. Vortex variations right now. Younger. I was still just a sprite, 39. Yeah. No, 2015. Yeah, 74. Oh, wait. Wait, what year are we in? We're in 21. Yeah, that's 7 years ago. Okay. 38. So you keep in mind that back in 2001, we didn't know you could take it off the body. I mean, that's how long I've been hooping. First, like, every year, there's, like, the old guard rebels against some new fad. The first fad that was ever rebelled against in my hoop world was lifts. Or not lifts, but it was keeping the hoop off body. So we're going to go, if you have to part ways, I understand it, I get it, but we're going to go maybe a little bit further, maybe 5 more minutes with this mix, so I can get my hoop in for the day, not for the day. With stories, and it's going to be based on the My Damn Darsha, so it's a blindfolded class. This is sort of the end. I'll play one sort of slowish song and let you kind of stretch or say goodbye or whatever. Thank you guys so much for being a part. Thank you for donations, by the way. I really appreciate that. I get them. I receive them. It feels like love to me, and I appreciate it. Jackie, for joining us and giving us updates. HoopPath. I love that idea. Wow. For those of you that don't know, Laura spreads a lot of hoop love. Fantastic hooper, great person, world traveler. Thank you guys so much. We really appreciate it.